Hi everyone, this is Brendan here and welcome to my next episode, Day 29 of my Let's Clash series. So let's start the episode by watching this GoWiPe on my base. So it's been quite a while since I see people using a GoWiPe. I mean, most of the time in High Champions League, I see people use a GoWiPe, which is an additional usage of the Witches. So this guy, he's going ahead to use a Golem, Wizard and just a P.e.k.k.play. And of course, using some Goblins following behind to steal my loot. So it's definitely going to be a 3-star because I don't have any strong single targeting defenses such as a high level Archer Towers, Tesla and also Cannons. So I don't even have even a level 1 Tesla at the moment, not even getting one of them. Although I do have a 3 available for me to get. But I'm trying to save the upgrade days as they take one day to upgrade, so I'll be using them to control my upgrade time. So going ahead to do my very own raid on this almost 1 million gold and elixir available base. So going ahead to attack and definitely focusing on the gold mines, they're all exposed. But not all the gold are inside the gold mine, there are some gold inside the gold storages. As I can see that the gold storages, they are pretty full. So, but not to worry, we will try to get all the loot from the gold mine and see how much we can get out from the gold mine. So going ahead to take all the loot from the gold mine, just focusing my troops a bit by bit, not spreading them as how I usually would deploy them, because I want to focus my troops on the gold mine. And I definitely will get the win because the town hall is outside and my troop is already sniping the town hall. So with the last gold mine over there being taken out, I've stole like almost 200, 300 over 1000 gold available already. So now going ahead to just wait for my archers to take down the town hall. And now with the help of the Barbarian King, although he's only level 1, but he still pack a punch and definitely getting me the 1 star. And going ahead with the next attack right now on this 235,000 gold available town hall 8. So focusing on the goal, and I was trying to get the win because I didn't want to lose the raid, because this is a relatively easy base to win because a lot of the buildings that are outside. So going ahead to try to focus on the goal mine first, and then I tried my luck to try to go ahead to get the 1 star. Seeing that I still had my clan castle and also my Barbarian King with me, I decided to try to break my way into the base. So just focusing my troops at that particular spot. And then my wizards, the level 5 wizards, they came out and they do a lot of damage. Although it's not as strong as level 6 wizards, but they still deal huge amount of splash damage. So now breaking through that particular wall, going ahead to do some more damage, and then after that trying to take out that gold mine on the right side, but then a lot of them got taken out and the wizard didn't go ahead to take that out. But not to worry, we are almost there, trying to get the 1 star now. And then now taking out that last elixir storage and getting us up to 50%, so I didn't lose that rate, so that was good. So going ahead on this not too high loot, just 215,000 gold available, but it's all on the outside. So I decided to go for it. And when I was attacking this, I was thinking, maybe I just take the gold and run away. Then I looked at it, it's quite easy to get the 50%. So I decided to just go and try for the 50% as I was kind of pushing my way to Crystal League, trying to get the 250 gems of achievement. And then just going ahead to deploy more of my troops, focusing on the top left and just dropping a minion over there. So now for those of you who have noticed, I've changed my troop army combo a bit. I've decided to use BAM, Barbarians, Archers and also Minions instead of using Barge. So I decided to add minions into my combo. Using one Dark Elixir Barracks to cook minion is still good enough. So usually I'll have like around 18 to 20 minions to bring along with me. Although they are only level 1, but if you use them wisely, like what you just saw, I deployed my one minion on top of the army camp over there. And the cannon definitely couldn't take it out because it could only attack ground troops. So there ain't any archer towers over there to take the minion out. So going ahead with this next attack, 280 over 1000 gold available. So focusing on the gold mine as usual first, and then focusing on the other structures. So trying to take out the rest of the base and trying to get the 1 star because it looks pretty easy to get the 1 star. So definitely it's going to be easy because the town hall is just outside on the right side. So getting the town hall first is my main priority so that I do not lose the attack. But then some of the gold mines, they were behind the wall, so I was thinking how to get it. So I decided to spread my troops around, and then after that dropping my clan castle, which the wizard will be able to help to take out that gold mine over there, which is quite deep. in my opinion. So it's quite hard for my troops to get it, but then with the help of the wizard, it's definitely going to go down. So all the gold mines have been taken out, just left with the town hall to go ahead to take it down. So we just wait for a while for the town hall to get taken out, and it's just going to be taken out in just a matter of a few more seconds. So just let my troops just go ahead to take it out, and then as you can see, it's taken out right now, and then just end the battle, scoring us 280,000 gold. So with the next attack, now as you can see, 300,000 gold available, which is a really nice find. Not too easy to find 300,000 gold available at, I would feel, at 1,400 trophies. I did push my way to 1,600, and I feel that 1,600 is easier to find. So I feel that the best farming range would be around 1,600, around that range for Town Hall 8. So I need to maintain my trophies around there. I can't drop my way to 1,003 or 1,004. That would be even more difficult and time consuming for me to farm. So as you can see, yesterday's farming wasn't too great, but today's farming, it was really crazy because I managed to push my trophies up a bit. I maintained my trophies in that range. I didn't want to go down to Silver League. In fact, Silver League was pretty bad for this Town Hall 8 to farm over there. So I do not want to go back down to Silver League. I'm going to farm at Gold League really a lot. So you guys will be seeing a lot of Gold League rates, and maybe probably even Crystal League rates. So hopefully I'll be able to maintain my account at the Crystal League, but I doubt that will happen because of my troops level, and also with my base, I'm bound to get 3-star a lot of times. So a lot of people will definitely go ahead and 3-star my base, and then my trophies will drop really quickly, and it's gonna be really tough for me to maintain, especially when I found that it's not easy to find town halls to snipe as compared to last time when I was farming my main account. I'm not too sure why. Maybe people, they are also maintaining their trophies in a way, so they do not want to lose raids. So now as you can see at my attack log, I've done a lot of raids and stole a lot of gold in like roughly 1 hour and like 8 minutes. I stole like almost 1 million over gold. So that was really, really nice. And of course, it's not every day or every time that I'm able to get all this kind of loot. So it's just today that I pushed my way up to 1,000, 4,500 that I found out that this is kind of a good farming range, so I didn't want to drop my way down. So I was testing the range out again. So last time when I was farming for Town Hall 8, I was around this range and it was pretty good. So some of you guys had said that to drop slightly lower, and I tried, and then I pushed my way up to like 1,007, 1,008. And I couldn't find an easy basis to attack. I could find like 600 of 1,000 loot available on a Town Hall 9, but it was like a kind of a maxed out Town Hall 9. And it was like close to impossible for my troops to go ahead to attack that max Town Hall 9, as I will probably even just get 100,000 gold from that base only. So finding this kind of a relatively easy basis to attack is what I'm trying to do right now, and then going ahead to just attack the base and then focusing on the other structures, especially that cannon over there on the right, which I use some minions to take it out. So that's the thing I really like about minions, which they can't be attacked by cannons and also by mortar because they are flying, and the cannons can only attack ground troops. So I really suggest to you guys to use some minions in your army combo, so as to be able to do this kind of attacks whereby the cannon, when it's exposed, you can just take it out with just one minion. Even for me, when I use a GoWiPe, I do use like one minion or two minions, so that whenever that there's a cannon over there protecting a structure and I need to snipe that structure, I will be able to use the minion to take it out, rather than to use an archer, then after that the archer would be able to be taken out by the cannon. So that's why a lot of people, especially those in high champions, they whenever they use some ground troops like 5 golems or 4 golems double jump strategy, they do use a one or two minions to just back themselves up, so as to not be be stunned by those cannon defending those structures. So now going ahead to take out the very last gold mine with my whole entire gang of minions, hoping that they'll be able to get more percentage. So looking at the situation right now, my Barbarian King is going down really quickly. So just left with the minions trying to take out the research lab over there. They got it down and then got the 50%, 2 stars. So now going ahead with the next attack on this Town Hall 9 with 231,000 gold available. So the loot, actually they are all inside the gold mine. So just focusing my troops on the right side, not even going to bother to go into the core of the base. space, especially when I can see that the storages, they are very empty. So now when you can see on the top left, the gold they are going is going down really quickly. So once it has reached to almost zero, then I will know that actually the gold, they are all inside the gold mine. So it actually reached to zero, so all the gold, they are inside the gold mine. So that was a really quick and easy attack, not even needing to use a lot at all my troops. So going ahead with this tower 7 with 350,000 gold available, definitely gonna go for it, because the gold, they are all on the outside, not on the inside. If it's all on the inside, especially if it's a tower 9 and they're all fully protected by very strong defenses, then there's really no point for me to go for it, because even if I can get like one storages, basically I won't be able to get like a 200,000 gold. So there's really no point to attack such high loot but really strong defenses bases. So this base is very easy to attack. So the very next one, this tower 9, is also very easy to attack because the tower is on the outside. So we're going to take out some of the defenses first before I take out the tower hall. So now going ahead to look at where the gold are. And it's not going to be easy because the gold mines, they are very separated, especially being protected by a lot of defenses. So now as you can see, the mortar on the outside is exposed. So dropping some minions to try to clear it out first before I drop my troops, and then just going ahead to let the minions to take out the rest of the other structures. And then the air defense have taken out some of my minions, but not to worry, I still have a lot of minions left. 9 minions is good enough to go ahead to take out the remaining gold mines. So going ahead to take out some of the gold mines on the right side first, then back to the left side because a lot of my troops, they went down. So took out that top gold mine, and then gold mine on the left side, there were two more. So I have my Barbarian King and also my clan castle with wizards to try my luck to take it out. So 160,000 gold available, and then especially now the wizards, they are not going the right way as to where I want them to go. Two wizards have gone on the outside, so I hope they will actually turn back around to go in. So one has listened to me and have gone in, but the other one have just continued to go up. But not to worry, we have taken out both of the gold mines and got an extra 90,000 out from it. So yeah, that was a really nice raid. So going ahead with this 234,000 gold available base, and definitely just gonna focus on the outside first, taking out the exposed structures before I go ahead to attack the base, because I want to score 1-star on the base. Not gonna lose a lot of my raids right now, because I'm trying to push my way to crystal as mentioned. So it's not a good idea to sacrifice my losses right now. So just patiently dropping my archers on the outside, waiting for them to clear a lot of the structures, and then just dropping some of my troops to go ahead to clear out more of the structures. And then I'm going ahead to deploy my troops on the right side and the left side also, in my usual manner, in a V-shaped manner, and then hoping that they will take out more of the structures. And then going ahead, as now you can see, a lot of the Barbarians have already ran out, so I'm just left with only archers and minions. So 23 minions left. Let's see how this is going to turn out, whether I'm going to use the remaining of my troops to try to take it out. So things going well, not too sure whether I need to drop my troop, but now as you can see, it's going to be a 1-star sooner or later. Don't even need to use any of my minions. So yeah, that was a really nice raid. So going ahead with the next attack, so using the same method, taking out the exposed structures first, and then after that slowly taking my time to locate where are the exposed buildings. So dropping some minions over there, minions won't be able to be taken out by the mortar, so not to worry about them. And then just going ahead to clear more of the exposed structures, slowly dropping my troop, not rushing my way. I didn't want to spam out all my troops because I do not want to lose the raid. So usually when I'm lazy, then I'll just spam my troops out using my 4 fingers or 3 finger strategy. So that's technically like a lazy way of farming. I just spam out my troops and just hope for the best. But of course, spamming it out smartly, and especially at those places where there are a lot of resources, not just anyhow deploying them. That's why I look at where and how the base is designed, then I will deploy my troops, not just focusing and not playing them properly. Especially at this kind of bases whereby all the structures, they're only on the outside at the bottom or one area, and then the rest of the other places, they do not have a lot of buildings on the outside. So there's no point to focus my troops on the other areas. So going ahead to win this attack with 1-star. So going ahead with this tower 7 with 368,000 gold available, a lot of loot. So we're gonna focus on the loot, just deploying my troops over there, and then we will see how, as now you can see I accidentally slide out my screen. And then a lot of the gold that are inside the gold mine, so it's gonna be an easy picking and gonna be an easy win because this is the tower 7. So tower 7, the number of structures available to build in as many as a tower 8 and also a tower 9. So the percentage increment will increase faster as the the buildings that are lesser, so that's why it's easier to attack lower town hall level when you're on a budge, especially if they are like town hall 7 or town hall 8. But for town hall 9 they have 72 structures, for town hall 10 they have 80 structures. So in order to get like a 50% on a town hall 10, if the town hall 10 has all 5 builder huts and all buildings are all built up, then you have to clear 40 buildings, which is not an easy task when a lot of the buildings that are all behind the wall and also well protected by splashed damage build defenses. So yeah, that's why I only attack like a low town hall levels right now. Once I get to 240 spaces or even getting my clan castle up and also my king and queen, I might attack a town hall 10 and also those max town hall 10s. So now as you can see, my walls, I've gotten 60 level 8 walls today, so that was really nice. And then going ahead to check out my profile with 124 attack wands already. Not too many that I did today, but it's really still good. And then especially now I'm still in Mega Asia, farming over there for the past roughly 2 days is really awesome. So the guys over there, they have been helping me a lot, giving me wizards, and of course I do use my spare account to give to myself. And I didn't donate that much to them, especially when my archers are only level 4. So I have to wait till they get to level 5, then I'll donate more to them. So yeah, that's it for this update that I'd like to update you guys for this episode. Hope you guys have enjoyed it as much as I have. So with that said, I'd like to thank you guys for watching my video, and clash on.